Hallelujah, praise the Lord. This is Prophetic Intercession with Amel. You're welcome. If this is your first time seeing me, thank you so much for clicking on this video. I know it is no coincidence. God pushed you to do that. And I pray this video blesses you in the name of Jesus. On this channel, we share the word of God. I give you prophetic words and prophetic declarations. As the Lord lays it in my heart and as He gives me utterance, I equally intercede for you. And I pray to God to bless you. Please kindly consider that to become a part of this family by subscribing to this channel and turning on the notification bell so that whenever there is a new content, you're going to be the first to know. And if this is not your first time, you know you've become my family and I love you. God laid this in my heart. I felt this burden and I thought I should reach out to someone. I'm here to ask you a question. Do you love God? What do you do for that? If your answer is yes, what are you doing for the one you love? God's greatest heartbeat is that people will repent and know Him. God's greatest heartbeat is that souls are saved. God is crazy about souls. That is His heartbeat. The Bible says God's heartbeat is that people should save and come to know the knowledge of the truth. What have you done to make sure that the gospel, this good news, go round? When was the last time you witnessed to someone? When was the last time you told someone about the love of God? About the sacrifices of God on the cross for their sake? When was the last time you won someone over to God? If this Christianity is a beautiful thing to you, when was the last time you introduced someone to it? Or what is Christianity to you in the first place? Is this just a means to an end? Did you come to God because you hear that God can bless you? Or you came to Him because you loved Him? You acknowledged His sacrifice for you and you've decided that you're going to populate heaven and depopulate the kingdom of darkness. What are you doing for God? It's very easy to ask God and we keep asking, God bless me, God do this for me, God do that. What are you doing for God? What are you doing to make Him happy? What are you doing to put a smile on His face? The Bible says there is joy in heaven when one soul repents. The Bible says when one soul repents, there is joy in heaven. What are you doing to make sure that there is joy in heaven? Are you only after God because of what He can give you? Or are you after Him because you love Him and you want to serve His purpose? If by any means you got to hear today that God will not bless you, if by any means you are convinced that the things you're asking from God He's not going to give you, are you still going to love Him? Are you still going to serve Him? Are you after God because of what He can give or because you love Him? The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and every other thing shall be added unto you. The prerequisite is to seek Him first. Other things are just bonuses. Are you in the kingdom because of the bonuses or because of God? Please, this is for everyone. Sharing the gospel is for everyone. Sharing the good news of the dead and resurrection of our Lord, the dead, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord is for everyone. It is not restricted to pastors, to preachers, to prophets. It is for everyone. We call it the Great Commission. The Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 28, from verse 18, I read, and Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, all authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. This is a great commission. We have all been called to preach the gospel. We have all been called to preach the good news, to witness to the lost. The Bible says that God's heartbeat is after souls. When people repent, there is joy in heaven. What are you doing to put a smile on God's face? Before you pray and ask Him to bless you, to give you money, to give you a kingdom spouse, to bless your children, to what are you doing? You want God to put a smile on your face. You want God to bless you. What are you doing to put a smile on God's face? Please, this is a call to reach out to the lost. Do something daily that reaches out to the lost. Every opportunity you have, witness to someone. Tell someone about the love of God. Tell someone about the death, resurrection, and ascension of Jesus into heaven. Tell someone. Whenever you have an opportunity, do not miss it. It is a great commission. It is for everyone. I don't want it to seem like, it doesn't have to seem like we are just in the kingdom because we are trying to use God. We are trying to get him to change our lives. Let's be real with God. Let's go after what pleases him as well. Even as he takes care of our own business, let's take care of his business, which is winning the lost to him. When you do that, he's going to bless you. But our main focus right now is not in the blessing. Our main focus is to make God happy. We just want to make him proud. We just want to make him happy. We just want to go after something that's going to give him joy in his heart. Please, if you're watching this video, it is no coincidence. God is talking to you. Reach out to someone today. Reach out to someone at every opportunity you have. Put a smile on God's face. And he's going to put a smile on your face. While not trying to bargain, it's not a give and take. Just try to be selfless about it. Serve God. Decide to serve God, whether he blesses you or not. Decide to reach out to the lost, whether God blesses you or not. He will bless you eventually. But just decide to make him happy. Put a smile on his face. Did you receive this word with gladness? Let us pray. Father, thank you for this beautiful word you have given to your children. Thank you for reminding them of the Great Commission and for reminding them of what is most important to you. Lord, please give us the grace to be able to please you, to go after the things that make you happy. Give us the grace, oh God, to be selfless in serving you. In the name of Jesus. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he cause his face to shine upon you. May he be gracious to you and may he give you peace. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.